हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एनालॉग आईएएस प्रीलिम्स हाई यील्डिंग सीरीज फॉर प्रीलिम्स 2020 एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेस वीडियो इज बोडोलैंड टेरिटोरियल काउंसिल. सो अलोंग विद अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया, रीजनल एस्पिरेशंस हैज टेकन अ टर्न इन द 1980s. सो द आइसोलेशन ऑफ द रीजन, इट्स कॉम्प्लेक्स सोशल कैरेक्टर एंड बैकवर्डनेस कंपेयर्ड विद अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री रिजल्टेड इन द कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सेट ऑफ डिमांड्स रेंजिंग फ्रॉम a demand for autonomy and opposition to outsiders. So the region which we're talking about right now covers an area of around 8,000 square kilometers and it is predominantly inhabited by Bodo people. So Bodo people along with other indigenous communities of Assam demanded autonomy, and the government of our country or the constitutional makers of that particular point of time felt that there is a need to give this set of people autonomy to ensure the unity and integrity of our country. So in that backdrop, the government has constituted under the 6th schedule of the constitution what we know as Bodoland Territorial Council. So this happened not at the time of constitution formation, but it is in 2003. But the idea of recognizing regional aspirations lies in the constitution of our country. So after an MOU was signed between the government of India, government of Assam and the Bodo Liberation Tigers to fulfill their economic, educational, linguistic aspirations. So there is this concept of relative deprivation in sociology. In order to ensure that regional aspirations are also taken into consideration, their specific developmental concerns are taken into consideration, this idea of providing autonomy is present. So if you take a look at the area of these Bodoland Territorial Council, it covers nearly four districts of Assam, namely Kokrajhar, Baksa, Chirang and Udalgiri. So these collectively constitute what we know as the Bodoland Territorial Administrative Districts. So the 6th schedule, if we have to summarize the concept and philosophy behind the 6th schedule, we can say that it is decentralized self-governance. So Article 244 and 275 have provisions with respect to this decentralized self-governance, and these states, which are namely Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, Mizoram, have 6 schedule areas. So which of the following is not one of the major communities residing in the Bodoland Territorial Council? In this context, you have to remember the controversy surrounding Hajongs. So the controversial tribal group Hajongs are native to the Indian subcontinent, but notably they are famous for their migration from Bangladesh. In the backdrop of this issue relating to NRC, these tribes were continuously in use. So if you understand that they are not a part of the indigenous tribes that are residing in this area, you can eliminate these options. You don't have to remember the rest of these options. So that is the logic behind this question. So the answer is D. Now please pause the video and try to answer this question. Please post your answer in the comment box below. That's it for this video. Stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.